Hey, what's up guys, I'm Styler, and in this video I'm going to review the Verny Mix 2 in black. If you're interested in this phone, remember to check the video description for more info and a link. So without any further ado, let's start the video. The Verny Mix 2 clearly resembles the Xiaomi Mix 2, however the Verny Mix 2 is both bigger and thicker. And the hardware is of course also not on the same level, but considering the price, you in fact get a pretty nice alternative. With the phone you get all the usual things, like a fast charger with 5V 2A, a standard micro USB cable, so here no USB Type-C, two thin screen protectors, one for the back and one for the front, a thick clear soft case, SIM tray pin, and last a standard English user manual. So we have the MediaTek Helio P25, which is an octa-core CPU clocked at 2.4 GHz, a non-removable 4200 mAh battery. We also have 6 GB of RAM and 64 GB of internal storage. Out of this internal storage we have about 50 GB left, but you also have the option to install a microSD card, which then will take up one of the SIM slots. The 8.2mm thin design feels solid, but with its 211g it's pretty heavy. So we have a black metal frame, we have a scratch resistant back made of glass, which unfortunately is a fingerprint magnet. In the top we have a single tone LED flash, which seems pretty strong, a dual rear camera setup with 13MP, which is supported by a secondary 5MP sensor. And when you try to cover the 5MP sensor, it will actually detect it, so it doesn't seem to be completely fake. On the front top we have a real ear speaker, proximity sensor and a notification LED, which will flash in blue and turn red when you charge the device. In the bottom we find an 8MP front facing camera with face beauty mode, and the 18:9 display is on 6-inch with the resolution of 2160 by 1080 pixels, protected by scratch resistant glass. The quality of the front camera is actually not bad, and in good light it is able to shoot pictures with a good amount of detail, while in low light the pictures fast get grainy, but that's normal for most budget phones. As for the display, it has decent colors with good sharpness, but we do have some very visible side bezels on 3.5mm, and in the top forehead the bezel is a few millimeter thicker on 5.5mm. as it also features a real but also very good and loud ear speaker. The viewing angles are good, the brightness is high and the outdoor visibility is fine. At the lowest setting the screen in fact instead seems a bit too bright. As for the sensitivity, it is good and fully optimized, so you can touch the screen in 10 places at the same time, and I haven't noticed any kind of problems while typing or playing games. In the settings you can customize the buttons or swap the on-screen back and reset buttons. In motion gestures we have flip to mute and three-finger screenshot. And the status bar can be fully customized, just like on the OnePlus 5. And last in about phone, you here see the build number, Android version, and that it has support for OTA wireless updates. So if you hold the volume button down for more than 1 second, it will activate the split screen mode. If you want to change the volume, just tap on the button. The rear fingerprint sensor works fine. I mean, like on most cheaper phones, it's not the fastest to wake and unlock. It takes like a second to turn on. However, it is accurate and can be used with no issues. We also have a 3.5mm headphone jack that provides good quality with high volume and good bass, and something we don't see on all phones today, so that's definitely a good thing. On the right side we find the power and volume keys, which are responsive but not completely solid, as they do rattle, not much but just a little bit. Moving to the bottom we notice the antenna lines, something that looks like two speakers, however we first have the microphone, a micro USB port and then the built-in bottom speaker. The speaker quality and volume I would say is very average for a budget phone, nothing special.
Hey, oh, hey, oh, hey. Hey, oh, hey, oh, hey.
As for the micro USB port, it supports USB on the go. So inside this phone we have a 4200 mAh battery, a pretty big battery, and getting through a full day on one charge is no problem. Here you see the Geekbench 4 battery test results with dimmed screen. All up to 11 hours is possible, but only as long you don't do any heavy stuff on the phone, while with normal mixed usage you will get about 6 hours screen on time. Fast charging does also work okay. I was able to charge the first 30% in 32 minutes, and a full charge takes about 2 hours and 10 minutes. The phone is using a very simple looking camera app. In video mode you can record up to 1080p. In photo mode you have settings like preview and picture size. And you also find stuff like anti-flicker and zero shutter delay, which does make a difference. We have face beauty, blur, where you can make a bokeh effect, but like on most budget phones, this also just seems to be a software gimmick, as it simply just creates a blurry circle around the center subject, but at least you here have two sliders that can be adjusted. Adding just a little bit will make it look more natural, and it is possible to shoot some okay good pictures. And the fake camera at least does notice if you cover the lens. For a phone in this price range, the pictures turn out okay. The rear camera is decent, but the focus is a bit slow and there is no optical image stabilization, and sometimes for no reason the exposure or color temperature seems to change a bit, though it is possible to shoot some good pictures if you just let focus correct. In daylight the video quality is quite good in 1080p, but the downside is again the autofocus, which is not the fastest, and each time it focuses it makes a clicking sound that afterwards also can be heard in the recorded video, and because of no optical image stabilization it can also look a bit shaky. Regarding the GPS, it works and has support for GLONASS, but it is definitely not the best I have seen. The lock and fix was kind of slow, and the signal reception and accuracy could be a lot better. As for the sensors, the phone has a real proximity sensor, so when you make calls it will turn off the display. It has a gyroscope sensor, ambient light sensor and compass, and the compass works fine as you see, without issues. And the same for the 360 VR videos on YouTube, so that's great to see. Moving on to the performance, the CPU used in this phone is in the middle class, so the score is not comparable with flagships. In Antutu it scores close to 67,000, which is very normal for a MediaTek Helio P25. 3D games like Asphalt 8 runs fast and smooth with only very few frame drops. It is not perfect, but still I enjoyed gaming on this phone. And regarding heating, I only experienced that it got a little bit warmer around the fingerprint sensor, which is normal, so it's nothing serious. The phone is using Android 7, multitasking is smooth and fast, and the launcher is very close to stock Android. It only comes out of the box with the Google Apps pre-installed, so free of any kind of bloatware. The network connectivity is fine on this phone, and it can connect to 3G, 4G and WoW LTE. And of course we also have support for LTE band 20. The only thing that could be improved is the Wi-Fi reception and range, which is only average but still usable. With the latest YouTube app you can play videos in 1080p at 60 frames per second, and now you can also zoom in all normal videos, so you can use that full 18:9 display. So now it's time for my final verdict. The Verny Mix 2 resembles the Xiaomi Mix 2, and it does a pretty damn good job. It looks amazing, feels good in the hand, and delivers good performance with a very nice display. For the price, you definitely get a cool smartphone that can be used for gaming, 360 VR, most standard apps, and normal daily usage with good battery life. On the bad side, we have the GPS, which is slow and not the most accurate, only average Wi-Fi reception. The built-in vibrator motor feels small and cheap. The phone is heavy, thicker and bigger than the Xiaomi Mix 2. And the cameras only deliver average picture quality with slow autofocus. But in the end, it's up to you if you can live with these pros and cons. Considering the price, it is overall a good phone with a lot of convenient features. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. Drop a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching this video and I hope to see you in my next one.